The following program contains language, images, and/or subject matter that may be objectionable to some viewers. Viewer discretion is advised.
Direct from Albany, New York, it's time for The Media Zone with your hosts, Ed and Dave. Tonight, a look at this week's new film and DVD releases. And the chance to win free movie tickets with the Poster Fairs game. And now your hosts, Ed and Dave!
Hello and welcome to the Media Zone. I'm Dave here. And Dave with you. Just talking about a part we had in the web series that I wanted Kim, the matinee lady, to do, but she's not doing any web series work any.
No?
Now, I guess. Ooh, it's hot. it's a little hot down here.
It's not.
On
it's
October
perfect.
4th. What
it's
do they call
perfect
that?
Perfect temperature.
The Indian summer? I think they call it.
No, I think they call it normal. There's just something wrong with you.
It's my sinuses. It's been damaged from 30 years in that hellhole I'm in there.
What does that got to do with your heat sensor?
Well, as we found out, I think I mentioned this before, your sinuses cool the air as it comes into your system. Now, when your sinuses are damaged from a building that has horrible air and dirt in it, and I have a picture on my phone if you want to do that later, then you get a lot of sinus infections and you get scar tissue in there and they'll cool down properly. That's what happened.
Oh. Well, welcome to Discovery Health, everybody. I didn't know that.
That we did. We learn things here.
We do.
We learned about colonoscopy, which is a story I don't think I... You know, I've told many odd stories, usually this about somebody else, but I don't think I can tell this one.
Why?
You told about your colonoscopy.
I did. Why? Are you ashamed, Ed?
It must
be done.
It's a natural act.
No, it's not natural.
It's not act.
It is not natural at all.
It wasn't my fault, so maybe we'll do the story later.
Your fault? What did you do?
Remember I told
you? I want to know.
Well, we will do it. I'll do it. What the
Well, heck? If it makes you feel any better, you had the colonoscopy the same day I had my prostate exam.
Now, how do they? They put a finger in there.
They do.
We will do some movies, including Girl on the Train, which is a big deal, apparently.
Then we have Middle School, The Worst Years of My Life, and you said The Girl on the Train.
And Birth of a Nation.
Birth of a Nation.
Which apparently is not anything to do with the original D.W. Griffith version.
Oh, wow. But yes, they do. That's how they do the prostate exam.
I've had that, too.
With a generous amount of lube.
But apparently there's a new thing, which they did on the Howard Stern show.
Okay.
It's something similar to what a woman might use. It's a long device.
Uh-huh.
And it goes in there and measures the actual size of the prostate, which I don't think you do with this.
It goes in the back door.
It goes in the back door.
And does it has to, like, spread to measure it?
No. Somehow it does it. It's got electrodes.
Oh, like
something.
A laser.
Laser kind of thing. I don't know how it works, but it's the size of a, we'll say, this is something you can use for your back.
Okay.
They call it in the stores. A vibrator. It's similar to a vibrator size. And it goes in the door back there, and it measures. So the wild antics of Richard and Sal on the Howard Stern show, they inserted these devices, and they called it a colonoscopy karaoke.
Oh.
So they had to sing. They started singing. And then the thing was inserted while they were singing.
Did they change their octave level?
And the octaves go, it's like Moon River. So they were doing karaoke like that. But I would think that would be a better measure of your prostate than a man going...
Well, I think...
They can't tell you how big it is. Can they tell you it's enlarged anyway?
Yes, they can.
From this?
Yes, because I've been told it's enlarged.
Okay.
I don't know. Or I've been told... I'm sorry. I've been told it's generous.
Oh.
It's generous.
It's a generous
But
size.
I think it works twofold because it's good to get the measurement. Okay. And the other thing that's good about it is, you know, I think from the physician's point of view, unless this is something he really enjoys doing, he can keep his hands out of that area.
Right.
I mean, you got to do it. It's important. As my urologist says when he's about to do the deed, he just says, I only ask you to do one thing. And I say, what's that? And he says, keep your feet in the ground.
Jesus.
And Casey.
Yes. And there you go. But as far as the colonoscopy, Ed.
Right.
I am a big proponent of getting that done.
You were always proponing that.
Proponing.
Right.
Sometimes when you have it done, your legs are akimbo.
Right.
But you need to have that done. For the love of God, people, I will say this again forever. That is not an area that you want cancer.
I know.
If you could prevent it. Mm-hmm. By just having that done, just do it. You only got to do it. Worst case scenario, I think it's like every 5 years if you have polyps.
If you have polyps.
Oh, you go every 10 if everything looks good.
Yeah.
Just do it, please.
He said when I had mine, well, if everything goes well, we'll see you in 10 years.
But, so is it 10 or 5?
Two polyps in there, so it looks like it's going to be 5. Yeah. And the worst part, they say, is the prep.
And you do not have a horrible prep story.
Well, you have to drink that Miralax, and you had to do that around 6 o'clock. But then they tell you do it the second batch 6 hours before, which would be like 5 a.m. And I didn't know how that was going to work. I thought
you're always up until 5 a.m.
Well, usually, yeah. So I didn't have a problem going a lot. There was some gurglings in there, and then I could often hold it in and then go. I didn't have to run or anything.
Did you get the baby wipes?
I got the baby wipes.
Very important.
That's a good idea. And remember I was joking about getting Depends?
Yes.
I said maybe I could cut down on a few trips if I got some Depends.
That's just horrible.
So I was there in just my, the boxer short type things with the characters on it. I don't know who I had on.
Whatever. SpongeBob
or something. So I was sitting on the couch, and it was after I thought was the end of the first batch of drainage.
Oh, no.
So I doze off on the couch.
That's a mistake.
The next thing I know, it's like 4 or 5 when I'm supposed to take my next batch. I said, okay, that's good. I'm waking up here. I fell asleep on the couch. All of a sudden, I get up, and my little shorts are moist. And so is the cushion I was sitting on. Apparently, most of my Miralax drained out in my sleep. So a good idea I'm going to suggest, you suggest people get their colonoscopy. I suggest maybe it is a good idea to put those Depends on
maybe.
In case you doze off on the couch.
I've often had the situation arise, and I've learned now that this is never the case, but when you are doing the prep work, and there's the gurgling and all that stuff, if you think it's gas, it is not. Even if you are 100% sure, this just feels like a typical, a pocket of air. I assure you, it is not. So don't just think, I think I can let this just little piece of air sneak out. Next thing you know, you're getting the resolve to clean whatever piece of furniture you were on.
Yeah, that cover went right in the washer. But after I woke up and took my next batch, I went on the bed and lied,
Face down
on my stomach like I always do,
okay.
And nothing came out. So I guess you have to don't fall asleep sitting up is the key here if you're going through your prep work at home.
All right. There you go.
A few little tips from my mistake.
Now we just need that little thing coming up behind us. The more you know.
The more. Let's see. Middle
school. Public service announcement has been brought to you by
Albany
Gastroenterology.
We brought many services to folks over the years to avoid Price Chopper was one of them. Now, did you see there was rumors that Price Chopper was up for sale?
Yes, but that's been squashed.
That's been squashed by Price Chopper, of course. Right. So there's something there. We have done our job, Dave.
You've done your due diligence.
Price Chopper will be going out soon.
All right.
All right. Well, let's see. Who has middle school,
Dave? I do, Ed.
Okay.
Middle school. The worst years of my life. Rafe has an epic imagination and a slight problem with authority. both collide when he transfers to an oppressive, rule-crazy middle school. Drowning in do's and don'ts, Rafe and his scheming best friend, Leo, hatch a plan to break every rule, every freaking rule, in the school's code of conduct. It's Ferris Bueller meets Home Alone as their battle with Principal Dwight explodes into chaos, both real and imagined. But Dwight displays his own fiendish creativity, striking back at the rule breakers.
Oh, God.
Meanwhile, Rafe struggles to hide his misbehavior from Jean, the straight-A overachieving girl of his dreams. Rated PG for rude humor throughout, language, and thematic elements.
Now, I believe this was from the Lionsgate Premiere Studio, which means, I believe it's shown up in a few theaters and on demand on the same day. But as there was no other films out this week, I had to include this one here. And by the look of this, it should be...
It should be direct-to-video.
Direct-to-video in the old days. Now it's direct-to-on-demand.
I think that guy does CarMax commercials. Him.
What?
Oh, really?
What, recently or an older one? Couple years, a failed match game. The current one is working as they renewed it. And he does CarMax? What is CarMax? Because they're building one where the Kmart was.
Guess it's a dealership of some sort.
Is it a used dealership?
It is? Okay, I didn't know.
So they have certified car, it's not CarFax, it's CarMax.
CarMax.
Huh.
That would be, CarFax is the Fox thing, isn't it?
Right, where you see how many accidents your car was in. Before you buy it.
Then how long is this clip?
two and a half. Maybe we don't need 2.5 minutes for...
Not when we have colonoscopies
no
to discuss.
No, stories.
Maybe we can go...
Well, I was going to say pull out of this, but... Jesus.
Oh, no, is it really? Yeah.
Everybody who was involved with car ads.
Apparently,
yes. Okay, Birth of a Nation.
Ooh.
We know that was a controversial Griffith film. But
D.W. Griffith. It was a silent film, wasn't it? Not.
Yes, which I had to sit through without even music in my film classes.
I wonder if it needs restoration.
Well, this is a new one here, this one. With Nate Parker and Armie Hammer and Mark Boone Jr. Set against the antebellum South. What is that? Somebody look that one up. The antebellum South. The Birth of a Nation follows Nat Turner, a literate slave and preacher whose financially strained owner Samuel Turner accepts an offer to use Nat's preaching to subdue unruly slaves. As he witnesses countless atrocities against himself and his fellow slaves, Nat orchestrates an uprising in the hopes of leading his people to freedom. Rated R for disturbing, violent content and some brief nudity.
Well, let's hope this,
version?
No, not version, but the leading an uprising. Let's hope that this film about an uprising does a little better than, say, the Free State of Jones, which did very poorly for Matthew McConaughey. And apparently had another film come out that made like a couple $1,000s recently.
Who was that?
It was Matthew McConaughey, but I can't remember the name of it. They said it made like $3,000.
Maybe he should go back to Bongos on the Beach.
I don't know.
I'm surprised they didn't put in here historical slave violence as one of the R ratings.
Oh, that's true, because we did have, what, Western Smoking?
We had the Western Smoking. I don't know what was the controversy over the original one. There was KKK in there.
The sensibilities back then was very different. And I don't know what year that was. Was it like 1917?
It was around there.
You know, sensibilities change over time, so.
He's got his Depends on. He's all set.
There you go.
He's okay. So this looks like nothing to do with the original Birth of a Nation, but similar, but slavery and things like that.
It's a film.
Nate Parker is starring and directing this. erasing all the memories of that original film. But historical in the sense of it's one of the first long feature-length silent films.
Right.
Usually with Lillian Gish, I think.
Lillian Gish. Didn't she live to be like 90-some years old?
Yes.
98, something like that. All right, let's move on to The Girl on the Train with Emily Blunt. Something about her.
Yeah, something about her. I don't like it. I don't know what it is.
I like it.
Yeah, it's something for everybody, though.
Yeah.
Is she doing it? The producer's grumbling. Is that positive grumbling? I'm not getting anything there.
There's Haley Bennett, another lovely young lady. Anyway, Rachel Watson's life post-divorce includes taking the train to work in New York, and every day the train passes by her old house. Well, I'm sure that triggers bad memories. The house she lived in with her husband, who still lives there, with his new wife and child. Hope the child's not named Reagan. As she attempts to not focus on her pain, she starts watching a couple who live a few houses down. Megan and Scott Hipwell. I didn't even see that. She creates a wonderful dream life for them in her head, and then one day as the train passes, she sees something shocking, filling her with rage. She turns green. The next day, she wakes up with a horrible hangover, various wounds and bruises, and no memory of the night before. That does sound Hulk-like.
Yes.
She has only a feeling something bad happened. Then come the TV reports. Megan Hipwell is missing. Rachel becomes invested in the case, trying to find out what happened to Megan, where she is, and what exactly she herself was up to that same night Megan went missing. Rated R for violence, sexual content, language, and nudity.
This has a Hitchcockian feel to it.
A what?
Hitchcockian feel. Now, who's the blonde? The blonde...
That's Haley Bennett.
What is she in?
She was in... The only other thing I've seen... She's been in several films, a lot of indies, but the only one I recall her being in that I've actually seen was a film called Music and Lyrics. With Drew Barrymore and Hugh Grant.
Oh, that had a catchy song in it, which I can't remember now.
Yes. I can't think
of
the name of it.
It's about songwriting.
Yes. Yeah. But I can't think of the name of it. It's...
Birds? Showers?
Way Back Into Love was the name of the song.
Uh-huh.
But I cannot...
Which film is Emily Blunt in where she's appealing looking?
The Werewolf.
Oh, the Wolfman?
Wolfman. Yes, Wolfman. I don't know. There's just something about her that...
What is it, Dave?
Maybe it's that mouth.
Is it the mouth?
I like the mouth. Yeah, there's just something about her.
Huh. I'm not getting it.
You know, it's kind of like...
I'm not getting any buzz off.
She's like the anti-Suzanne Summers to me.
Oh, jeez. completely. Why is that?
I mean, you take Suzanne Summers bit by bit. Each piece looks kind of good, but when you put it all together, it's kind of a mess.
Huh.
But Emily Blunt, you take the pieces bit by bit, and you're like, it's just that. But you put it all together, and it's like, that's nice. I like that.
I'm gonna look.
Something about her.
I'm gonna try and find some good pictures of Emily Blunt.
I think she's married to that John Krasinski.
Huh.
From what was he in, The Office?
Yes.
Oh, I never watched that one.
I never saw it either.
Let's see.
There's something about her. Plus, she's British.
British. That works sometimes.
Sometimes.
Let's see. DVD releases. We're a little late. Boy, we have some other material we can get to. We'll get to something here. Hotel.
I've never seen an episode of this show.
Huh. This wasn't a terrific season, but it was okay. I still haven't seen the Asylum season, which I do have.
How many episodes? Each season?
13.
That's too many.
Too many to keep your
interest. Yeah, if there was six, maybe.
Trying to think. I'll tell you which the best one was, if you want to. Now, I vaguely remember this, but never saw it. It was 1974. These people are put into an underground room that's programmed for survival. It's got all updated, things, and it's like a bunker.
Mm-hmm.
But they forgot there's bats down there somehow.
Oh.
Do you remember this at all?
No.
No. I gotta see this. Chosen Survivors. I think it's like a disaster type thing. I'll see it.
Daughter of Dracula.
This is a Jess Franco film, which was a Spanish director who did his own type of Hammer.
And I'm sure there was a bevy of bosoms.
With bosoms, the bosomy hammer girls we all enjoy. I don't remember this film, though, at all. Now, these are the same Minion movies that have been out for years, but we're going to put them in a lamp here and try and sell them over again.
Oh, okay.
Put them in a little Minion lamp.
Three movies plus a Minion lamp.
People love these collectible items.
Ed.
And probably not this one, but others I do. Now, I was surprised there's three titles. Well, I guess it's either Christmas or holidays.
Are these all Hallmark movies?
The Hallmark Channel. We got Hitch for the Holidays.
I've seen them all.
The Christmas Ornaments. Come Dance With Me. Now, it doesn't have holiday or Christmas in the title. I don't know how that happened. And the very Merry Mix-Up, I think Merry.
Hitched for the Holidays. I've seen each one of those.
Oh, no. Why?
I watch the Hallmark Christmas movies.
Oh.
I watch them all.
Are they good, or you just start watching them and they're all the same, pretty much?
Pretty awful for the most part, but I don't know why I'm about to say this, but there's a certain charm to some of these movies where they're actually watchable.
Huh.
And depending on who the actor or actress is, if they're likable enough. I mean, even Henry Winkler was in one, which was actually pretty good.
I'm going to tell you what the premise is just looking at this cover here.
All the same.
The premise is a guy and a girl, either in a red or green outfit.
Christmas! It's the Christmas colors, Ed. Come on!
The girl has a green top and the guy has a red one up there. Then it's switched down below.
I think I've mentioned this before. There were two new Hallmark Christmas movies, last year. One was about an actor who couldn't find a job, moved back to his hometown, got a job, and was going to move away, but was brought back because of the girl he fell in love with. Then another one was about an actress who couldn't find a job, moved back to her hometown. They're the same thing.
Didn't you say one was the worst movie he ever saw? It was so bad. The guy was bad looking or something.
Oh, yeah. That's I can't think of the name of that one. Oh, Christmas Magic.
Christmas Magic.
To see that. It is so awful. I DVR'd it. I watch it every Christmas time. I have to. It's so bad. Bad story, bad acting, and an incredibly unattractive man who is the love interest of this fairly attractive woman. It's just awful. Watch it. But I've seen all the Hallmark movies. I'm a romantic, Ed. What can I say?
Now, Knight Rider on Blu-ray, Dave. This is something that should be preserved in Blu-ray quality. The Knight Rider series.
Never saw an episode.
I'm wondering how much better this is going to look. Because it's 80s quality. I guess it was shot on film, but TV ratio film. You'll have to see. I might get it when it's marked down.
Or if they sell it in the car. Yes, it's like that car. That's out in the garage.
Oh, no. Now, the Lord of the Rings fans are in an uproar, Dave.
Why is that?
They're repackaging those films. And just the extended edition, not the original versions, but they're in this nice collectible bookcase thing for $600.
Oh, $600.
Lord.
And someone's going to buy this. People will buy it.
Now, you can buy the films marked down about $4 now.
And then build a bookcase.
Build your own bookcase. And it's kind of a shame that when you're going to double dick. Double dip. Put that for our blooper reel there. Double dip, people.
I've only done that once.
Okay, we got a couple more here, and then we got to get to the game.
All right, The Purge, election year.
Just out. Got to put...
What's funny about it is it says it's the best Purge film yet, which means there are multiple Purge films.
Right. I think that was the third one. Oh, Sharknado. This one was kind of entertaining. Did anybody watch this one?
No.
No. All right, I'm going to get right over to the board, Dave.
All right, it's time for the Post to Pairs game, folks, as we see Ed exiting the area.
Oh, I hope my shirt was down.
It was. Thank you very much. This is where you send in an email with two numbers from 1 to 6. We select your entry, reveal what's between the numbers you've given us, and if they match, You win 2 free movie passes. If you're right, spin the wheel. We'll spin the wheel. You can win up to 10. Over to you, Ed.
The next show is going to be Shake-Up Show because, once again, I forgot.
Well, you had that colonoscopy to discuss.
Right. That was very important to get out because we have to get the news that you're better off buying Depends.
It's our public service announcement. Please, people, have the colon. I cannot emphasize that enough. All righty. It is interesting. Gary.
Huh.
3 and 5. 3 and 5 this time.
I was going to say cut to Dave for a minute because I'm going to sneeze. We got to go. What's up?
3 and 5. Let's see if he wins again. Didn't he win?
He did. And we spun the wheel with the same one, the Kulshak. If Kulshak moved over here,
I think
that's
it was
the last time.
Wasn't it the up and down ploy?
It was
time?
Here last time. Oh, not this time, though. It's the old opposite. No. Opposite end ploy, that's another one. Ah. Up and down, and then opposite ends
and
again.
Pretty soon we'll have the, it's the old sequential James Bond ploy.
That one we're not going to have.
All right, folks, you want to enter this extremely exciting game, you can do so by sending an email to mediazone95@gmail.com. MediaZone95@gmail.com.
I'm covering my microphone. Did you hear that at home? I'm sure you did.
Send 2 numbers by email from 1 to 6. We reveal you win, and you can spin a wheel. You can win all those tickets. There you go.
Yeah.
I don't know why he's hurrying us along. We got like 3 minutes left.
3 minutes. We do have 3 minutes.
Oh, geez.
Nothing that
now
I
we
can
gotta have dead air.
Get in here. Oh, well, I had to go to a wedding at the Glenn Sanders Mansion,
Dave. That's a lovely establishment.
It is if you're on the bottom floor. If you're on the top floor in a 90-degree heat.
Oh, and we all know how you are with temperature because of the sinus issue that we learned earlier.
Right. So apparently upstairs, and I knew it was bad. I had a bad feeling when they pointed that it was up. The thing was upstairs. I just had visions of my mind of that super knocked up taping when I was upstairs. And by God, for some reason in these old joints, we can't cool down the upstairs. And when somebody told me somebody was nice enough to bring a fan in, I said, oh, we're in big trouble up here.
Boy.
So immediately the suit I was forced to wear came off and the tie. And it was quite hot up there, and I ventured down many times to the night. The downstairs was like an icebox.
Right.
But the upstairs is kind of hot.
And were you with your wife?
I was with the wife.
And did she feel the same way about the temperature?
Not quite as bad as I was, but still hot overall. So please, when you're looking into your wedding reception areas, inquire as to the air conditioning availability.
Or if you're going to do it there, have it in January.
Right. Probably cold as ice up there in January. But
heat rises.
Heat does rise, so maybe you're better off. That's a quick story to fill in. 2 minutes at the end there.
All right. Let's just sign off early then, because you know what? I have places to go.
Okay, we'll sign off. Next time, we're going to shake up the show next time because we got a few things we're going to put in. I got to get some things in because I brought them down. So we're going to do those maybe even before the movies.
Ooh.
Because other than Godzilla, I'm looking at some movies that could be dropped if needed. So we'll see that.
From a movie show.
From the
Let's
movie
drop
show.
The movies.
Right. We're going to have fun next time. Shake it up, Media Zone, next time as we enter October.
In our penultimate season.
Right.
The Media Zone has been a Cable 2000 production.